सहनावतु सहनौ भुनक्तु सहवीर्यं करवावहै तेजस्विनावधीतमस्तु मा विद्विषावहै ॐ शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः ॐ पूर्णमदः पूर्णमिदं पूर्णात् पूर्णमुदच्यते पूर्णस्य पूर्णमादाय पूर्णमेवावशिष्यते ॐ शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः श्रुतिस्मृतिपुराणानाम् आलयं करुणालयं नमामि भगवत्पादम् शङ्करं लोकशङ्करं शङ्करं शङ्कराचार्यं केशवं बादरायणं सूत्रभाष्यकृतौ वन्दे पुनः पुनः ईश्वरो गुरुरात्मेति मूर्तिभेदविभागिने व्योमवद्व्याप्तदेहाय दक्षिणामूर्तये नमः प्रणम्य रामाभिधमात्मधीपदम् जगत्प्रसूतिस्थितिसंयमायनम् तदात्मकान् शङ्करपूर्वकान् गुरुन् मयोपदेशार्थविभाग उच्यते in the 60th passage. The disciples say, katham tarhi pratyakshadi apasiddhātmane dehadhyārūpaṇa dehache ātmārūpaṇa iti pratyakshadi apasiddhātmane ātmā that is not known perceptually as an object. How can there be, like in the rope snake, which is known perceptually, upon that the adhyarupana, superimposition of snake, etc. can take place, but Atma does not fall in that category. Deha is Atma rupana, and then Deha is non-existent in Atma, upon that how can there be arupana, superimposition of Atma? Nam doshaha svabhav prasiddhatvad atmanah. It is not necessary that the adhisthanam, the substratum, upon which the superimposition takes place, has to be known as an object. Has to be known, that's all. Na kadachit katva siddhau eva adhyaropana na nitya siddhau iti niyantum shakyam. Something that is known incidentally now and then, this is called perception. The object of person like ghata pata can be known only when my organ of perception, I, comes in contact with that. Because a pot is not self-effulgent, it can reveal itself only when illumined by the light of consciousness emerging through the eyes. Then where a pot is known, kadachit kataya, now and then. Because it is not self-effulgent. So Atma is different. It is always known because it reveals itself, is self-effulgent. That does not matter. So difference between a self-effulgent entity such as Atma and a paraprakasya, an inner entity such as ghata is that Atma is always effulgent, whereas ghata pata are effulgent now and then. So rope can become the object of superimposition only when it is known by you. Not always. When the rope is perceived. And that too, it is pursued. We used to say that the rope has the samanyamsha and the visheshamsha. Samanyamsha is idam and visheshamsha is the rajyutvam. Even that is not necessary. That the rope should shine in your awareness. That's all that is necessary. And should shine in a manner which is adhyasa virodhi akarana asphuram cha. Suranam is necessary that the rope should become the object of awareness. And again, the rope should shine in your awareness in a manner which is unopposed to the superimposition. Meaning that the rope shines as I am. It is not opposed to any adhyasa. If rope shines as rope, it is opposed to adhyasa, understand? If rope shines as rope, that is opposed to any kind of superimposition because there is viveka jnanam, the knowledge of rope as it is, therefore adhyasa, there is ignorance there. So not only should rope shine in your awareness, it should shine in a manner which is unopposed to superimposition of snake and you know, mala, etc., etc. That's all. It is not samanya, vishesha, etc. Because that kind of thing can exist and still adhyarupa may not take place. But this condition exists, that a knowledge becomes the object of awareness. And in such a manner, whether it is not samanya vishesha, in such a manner that is not opposed to superimposition. Meaning that if the rope is known as rope, then it is known as it is, therefore adhyarupa cannot be. If the rope is known as this, then it is not opposed to adhyarupa. Similarly also, atma has to be known, not as an object, subject doesn't matter. And atma should be known in a manner which is unopposed to the various superimpositions. So atma is known as ahamasmi, sadabhami. But it's not opposed to taking myself as jiva, etc., karta, bhokta. So ahamasmi is not opposed to kartrutvam or bhoktrutvam. Aham akarta, aham abhokta, when I know myself that way, then that is opposed to kartrutva, bhoktrutva. Then adhyasa cannot take place. Vedanta janita jnana asati. Only Vedanta janita jnanam is there that aham akarta karmanya karmaya pashed akarmana cha karmaya neva kinchit karomiti. If this is my knowledge about myself, then I am akarta, abhokta, ajo nitya shashvatoyam purana. In that manner, if I know, then that knowledge is opposed to any kind of superimposition because it is the knowledge of Atma as Atma is. But here, Atma just is. Anudra also can be, Mithya also is. And Atma is. Jadam also is. And Atma is. Then Antavatma also is there. Atma is. Dukkhitva also is there. So this Anuritatvam, Jadatvam, Dukkhitvam, Antavatvam, Anatmatvam, none of them is opposed to easiness. You follow? Meaning easiness is available for this kind of superimposition. Easiness doesn't say that, hey, I am not Anuta. Akarta says, I am not Karta. But I am is available for any kind of superimposition because I am is not opposed to myself being jiva, karta, bhokta, sukhi, dukhi. So, na kaschid dosha. So, this is the condition for adhyarupa. Then the question is, now it is established that there is a mutual superimposition of atma and anatma that is established. That anatma is swarupataya adhyarupita upon atma and atma is only samsargataya adhyarupita upon anatma. That's all understood. When that is settled now, dehakim bhagavan dehatmanoho itar etar adhyasa adhyarupana. ದೇಹಾದಿ ಸಂಘಾತ ಕೃತ ಅಥವಾ ಆತ್ಮಕೃತ ಇದೆ. ನೌ ಯು ಸೇ ದಟ್ ದಿ ಅನಾತ್ಮ ಇಸ್ ಸೂಪರ್ ಇಂಪೋಸ್ಡ್ ಅಪಾನ್ ಆತ್ಮ, ಆತ್ಮ ಇಸ್ ಸೂಪರ್ ಇಂಪೋಸ್ಡ್ ಅಪಾನ್ ಅನಾತ್ಮ. ಹೂ ಬ್ರಿಂಗ್ಸ್ ಅಬೌಟ್, ಹೂ ಕ್ಯಾರೀಸ್ ಔಟ್ ದಿಸ್ ಸೂಪರ್ ಇಂಪೋಸಿಷನ್? ಇಸ್ ಇಟ್ ಅನಾತ್ಮ ದಟ್ ಸೇಸ್ ದಟ್ ಅಹಂ ಸಂಸಾರಿ, ಆತ್ಮ ದಟ್ ಸೇಸ್ ಅಹಂ ಸಂಸಾರಿ? ಸೊ ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ವಾಟ್ ದ ಶಿಷ್ಯ ಆಸ್ಕ್ಡ್. ಶಿಷ್ಯ ಅಭಿಪ್ರಾಯ ಶ್ರೋತು ಕಾಮಃ ಗುರು. ಗುರು ವಾಂಟ್ಸ್ ದ ಶಿಷ್ಯ ಟು ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪ್ಲೈನ್ ವೈ ಈಸ್ ಈ ಆಸ್ಕಿಂಗ್ ದಿಸ್ ಕ್ವೆಶ್ಚನ್. ಸೊ ವಾಟ್ ಈಸ್ ದ ಪ್ರಯೋಜನ, ವಾಟ್ಸ್ ಎ ಪರ್ಪಸ್ ಬಿಹೈಂಡ್ ಆಸ್ಕಿಂಗ್ ದಿಸ್ ಕ್ವೆಶ್ಚನ್? ಸೊ ಟೆಂಟೇಟಿವ್ಲಿ ಗುರು ಆಸ್ಕ್ಡ್, ಈ ದೇಹಾದಿ ಸಂಘಾತ ಕೃತ ಅಧ್ಯಾರೋಪಣ ಇದು ಜ ಆತ್ಮಕೃತ ಕಿಂ ತತ್ರ ಸ್ಯಾತ್ತವ, ವಾಟ್ ಡಸ್ ಇಟ್ ಮ್ಯಾಟರ್ ಟು ಯು? ಅಧ್ಯಾರೋಪ ಇಸ್ ದರ್, ವಾಟ್ ಡಸ್ ಇಟ್ ಮ್ಯಾಟರ್ ಟು ಯು ವೆದರ್ ಆತ್ಮ ಸೂಪರ್ ಇಂಪೋಸ್ ಇಟ್ಸೆಲ್ಫ್ ಆನ್ ಅನಾತ್ಮ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಸೇ ಐ ಆಮ್ ಸಂಸಾರಿ, ಓರ್ ಅನಾತ್ಮ ಸೂಪರ್ ಇಂಪೋಸ್ ಇಟ್ಸೆಲ್ಫ್ ಆನ್ ಆತ್ಮ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ದೇಹಾದಿ ಸಂಘಾತ ಸೇಸ್ ಐ ಆಮ್ ಸಂಸಾರಿ? ವಾಟ್ ಡಿಫ್ರೆನ್ಸ್ ಡಸ್ ಇಟ್ ಮೇಕ್ ಟು ಯು? Now, then we proceed with the passage 64. Tika says, Swabhiprayam shishyah prakatayate ityah ityuktah ide. Shishyah ಸ್ವಾಭಿಪ್ರಾಯಂ ಪ್ರಕಟ ಇದೆ. ಸೊ ವೆನ್ ದ ಗುರು ಆಸ್ಕ್ಡ್ ದಿ ಅಭಿಪ್ರಾಯ, ವಾಟ್ ಈಸ್ ದಿ ಇಂಟೆನ್ಷನ್ ಆಫ್ ಪರ್ಪಸ್ ಬಿಹೈಂಡ್ ಯುವರ್ ಆಸ್ಕಿಂಗ್ ದಿಸ್ ಕ್ವೆಶ್ಚನ್? ಸೊ ಅಭಿಪ್ರಾಯಂ, ದ ಶಿಷ್ಯ ನೌ ರಿವೀಲ್ಸ್ ಹಿಸ್ ಅಭಿಪ್ರಾಯ, ದ ರೀಸನ್ ವೈ ಆಸ್ಕ್ ದಟ್ ಕ್ವೆಶ್ಚನ್. ಯು ಡೋಂಟ್ ಆಸ್ಕ್ ಕ್ವೆಶ್ಚನ್ ಫಾರ್ ಸೇಕ್ ಆಫ್ ಆಸ್ಕಿಂಗ್, ದೇರ್ ಇಸ್ ಆಲ್ವೇಸ್ ಎ ಪರ್ಪಸ್. There is something that is either bothering you or something is not clear to you, there is a doubt in you. So there can be various reasons for asking a question. Or you are questioning somebody. So what is the reason here which makes the shishya ask this question, who is superimposing upon whom? ಇತ್ಯುಕ್ತಃ, ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಪ್ಯಾಸೇಜ್ ಸೇಸ್ 64. ಇತ್ಯುಕ್ತಃ ಶಿಷ್ಯಾಃ ಯದಿ ಅಹಂ ದೇಹಾದಿ ಸಂಘಾತ ಮಾತ್ರಃ ತತೋ ಮಮ ಅಚೇತನತ್ವಾತ್ ಪರಾಸತ್ವಂ ಇತಿ ನ ಮತ್ಕೃತಾ ದೇಹಾತ್ಮನೋಃ ಇತರೇತರ ಅಧ್ಯಾರೋಪಣ. ಸೊ ಪಾಯಿಂಟ್ ಇಸ್, ಹೂ ಇಸ್ ದ ಒನ್ ಹೂ ಸೇಸ್ ಐ? ಡಸ್ ಆತ್ಮ ಸೇ ಐ ಆರ್ ಅನಾತ್ಮ ಸೇಸ್ ಐ? ಹೂ ಸೇಸ್ ಐ? ಯದಿ ಅಹಂ ದೇಹಾದಿ ಸಂಘಾತ ಮಾತ್ರ, ಸಿದು ಹೂ ಇಸ್ ಐ? ಐ ಇಸ್ ದ ಒನ್ ಹೂ ಸೂಪರ್ ಇಂಪೋಸಿಸ್. Question was, there is anatma that is superimposing itself on atma. Who takes the initiative of superimposition? Or is it atma that superimposes itself upon anatma? So who is this I? Is dehadi sanghata I that superimposes itself I-ness upon atma? So dehaditva upon atma, because dehoham, manushyam is our experience. Raham belongs to Atma and Manushyatva belongs to Dehadi Sanghata Anatma. So then, who is it I which says I am Manushya? Is it Atma that says I am Manushya? Or the Dehadi Sanghata says I am Manushya? Yadi aham Dehadi Sanghata Matra. If that I is Dehadi Sanghata, meaning this Sanghata, the assembly, or aggregate of deha, the of deha, the body, sense organs, mind, intellect, if that assembly says I, ततः मम अचेतनत्वात् इट्स वेल नोन दैट द बॉडी सेंस ऑर्गन्स ऑल ऑफ दीज आर प्रोडक्ट्स ऑफ मैटर एंड दे आर अचेतन मीनिंग दैट पर प्रकाश दे आर इनसेंशेंट नॉट सेल्फ रिवीलिंग परातत्वमिति अचेतनम इज ऑलवेज परार्थम एनीथिंग दैट इज अचेतनम विच इज इनसेंशेंट अनइंटेलिजेंट lifeless necessarily is meant for someone else. So that's why the Christians say the whole universe, you know, is meant for you. Enjoy it. Because that's so, the animals don't have soul. So they're meant for your food. You know, that's how. And the nature also is, has no soul. And so it's all meant for you. That's why they went on exploiting and then, you know, this nature and all animals, everything, and destroyed it. Anyway, whatever. So, parārthatvam, acetanam, like this body is acetanam, therefore parārtham serves the purpose of someone other than the body. Meaning, body doesn't have the freedom. Body is totally dependent upon something else to use it. It is meant for someone else's use. So there is no freedom. Aparathamiti. So then, see, to do so, adhyaropa requires freedom. Who decides to adhyaropa? Atma decides to adhyaropana or anatma? Anatma dehadi sanghata is achetana, therefore is parartha, meaning doesn't have the freedom, and therefore namatkruta dehatmanoho itaretar adhyaropana. If I am body, etc., dehadi sanghata, then I being achetana, not being free, swatantra to do anything, therefore I could not have done this adhyaropana. So the Tika says, anātmanah svarūpeṇa adhyastatvāt nisvavāvasya tasya adhyāsa kartrutva anupattehe ātma eva tatkartā iti svayam uhamānah. See, Shishya is already thinking in his mind. He established that anatma is sarupena adhyasta. Atma is samsargena adhyasta. Anatma sarupena. What is meant by that? When anatma is sarupena, a sarupa superimposed of anatma, which means that anatma does not exist in atma. Anatma ceases to be anatma by superimposition. Where atma samsargana adhyasa, atma remains atma and appears to be superimposed. Follow. So anatmana swarupena, so anatma is superimposed swarupena as its own self. Adhyastatva nisvabhavasya, anatma has no existence of anatma, established that adhyasta is non-existent upon in adhisthana. Tasya adhyasa kartru anupatte. If anatma dehadi sangata does not really exist, I mean that's called parārthatvam. Its existence also is because of something else. The rope snake derives its existence from rope. Rope snake is parārtha or has no existence of its own. Similarly also, the dehadi sangata anatma has no existence of its own, derived existence of atma. Then how can it superimpose that which does not exist on its own? Doesn't have freedom to do anything. Therefore, nisvavasa tasya adhyasa kartrutva anupatte. That which does not have its own existence cannot do superimposition because it doesn't have any svatantrata, doesn't have intelligence. Then of the two now, The fact is adhyasa is there, manushyam that anubhava is there. Anatma cannot bring about that anubhava, therefore, again, by the law of the elimination, atma eva tarta tat karta idi. So, parishesha nyayana, if anatma is not the adhyasa karta, then atma is adhyasa karta. He is swam uhamana. So, this is what the shishya reasoned within himself and said that this has to be so. Now, how did shishya arrive at this conclusion? The Tika says, aham avabhasasya atma pratyayatvat sangatecha taddarshanat sava aham anyova adhyasa karta iti ubhayatra dosham upanyasyate shishyah ityah yadi aham ityadinan. Aham avasasya manushyoham. I am a human being. Aham. So aham is avabhasa, shining in this manner. Atma pratyayatvat. That aham avabhasa belongs to atma. Atma pratyayatvat. In aham manushya, aham also is shining, manushya also is shining. That aham is centered upon atma. Sangate cha tad darshanat. If aham belongs to atma, in body also the aham is there. When I say aham manushya, then manushya belongs to sanghata. So that's why we find aham. When I say I am a human being, that means sanghata is taken as I. So I belongs to atma and I the sanghata, that manushyoham, that then it looks like that I-ness belongs to manushya or sanghata also. Sanghata icha tad darshana. Aham belongs to atma also, because aham should belong to atma. But at the same time, in the body also, I say, I am manushya, therefore, sangate cha tad darshanat. Aham, the I-ness is seen in this sangata also. Our experience is that, we know that I-ness belongs to atma. But in body also, I say, I am fat, lean, etc., therefore, sangate cha. The I-ness also is observed to be there in the Sanghata, in the body-mind-sense complex. Savaham anyava adhyasa karta. So who am I, that Atma I am, or other than Atma, the adhyasa karta? Who brings about the adhyasa? Either Atma brings about adhyasa because aham means Atma. Or anatma carries out adhyasa because manushyatva also, there is aham in there. So, aham seems to have these two locations. Atma also is aham, and dehadi sangat also is aham. And therefore, when I say manushya, who is this one who is saying that? Is atma saying I am manushya? Or the dehadi sangat says I am manushya? Uvayatra dosha upanyasyati. Both of these positions are untenable. Shishya find that none of these explanations is satisfactory. And there were the question. So he brings out his intention. So then, Shishya continues. Atha aham atma paraha anyaha sanghatat chitimatvat swartha heti maya eva chitimata atmani adhyarupana kriyate sarva anartha bija bhuta. So if I am the dehadi sangat is I, dehadi sangat achetana, lifeless, and therefore that cannot carry out adhyarupana, so dehadi sangat cannot be I. Then atma is I. Atha aham atma paraha anyaha sanghatat. Atma, I am atma who is other than the sanghata. Paraha and anyaha, other than that and that which transcends the sanghata. That is called the samsarga adhyasa. where the adhisthanam transcends the adhyastha. That is called the Surupa Adhyasa, where adhyastha becomes one with adhisthanam and never loses its existence, whereas Samsara Adhyasa, adhisthanam retains and it transcends, so it only appears to be only superimposed. Aham atma para insangata tanya. Sangatat para sangata tanya. Chitimatvat, because I am consciousness, swartha evaiti, meaning I am self-existent, self-effulgent, I serve my own purpose, I am independent. Then maya eva chitimata atmani adhyaropana kriyate. Because anatma cannot carry out adhyasa, because it is parartha, it is jada, doesn't have freedom. Atma is swartha, serves its own purpose, it is free. Of the two, only atma, there is consciousness, alone can carry out the adhyaropana. So he worked it out. So then what's the problem? Then sarva anartha bija bhuta adhyaropana kriyate. The adhyaropa that atma carries out is sarva anartha bija bhuta, is the source of, the cause of all anartha, all calamities, all suffering. This is what Upanishad describes by saying tat srishtva tadevana pravishat. Anena jivena atmana anupravishya. So Vashyakara explained clearly in Chandogya Upanishad that pravesh or entry of the atma into this anatma is like the entry of the sun into a pool of water, which looks like an entry, not a real entry. If someone does not know the true nature of sun, he may think that sun is inside. Similarly, one who does not know the true nature of atma believes atma is inside and limited by this body, mind, sense complex. In reality, there is no pravesha. In reality, there is no limitedness. The limitedness of the atma is an appearance like the limitedness of the sun. So just as even when the sun appears to be limited as a reflection, it is not limited. So when the atma appears to be a manushya, jivatma, etc., even then also it is not. This is very important. So that is why they say samsarga adhyasa, new term. That crystal, even when it appears to be red, it is not red. Then, that means atma is on its own, carry out this adhyaropana, superimposed. Why? Why should Paramatma enter this miserable thing, you know? Which is entering a prison, where there is nothing but pain and sorrow. So that also doesn't make sense. Anatma cannot make adhyaropana. Atma alone can make adhyaropana. But then where is the sense of atma on its own superimposing itself on an atma? Which superimposition is the cause of all sorrow in the life? Sarva anartha bija bhuta adhyaropana. So who will on his own enter the prison and accept all the suffering? Why should atma do that? So that also doesn't make sense. Of the two, atma alone can carry out this adhyaropa and not an atma. And if atma carry out adhyaropa, it doesn't make sense because it is inviting all the misery on its own when it is free. See, atma is not svatantra. In that case, you are arrested and put into prison, there is nothing you can do. But can someone say, here I am, come, let me enter the prison and you beat me up, and who will do that? So this also doesn't make sense that atma should do the adhyaropana. So the tika said, adye pakshe adhyasakartuhu abhavat samsadarshanam nasyat iti bhavah. Adye pakshe means anatma superimposing itself on atma. But because by the time anatma goes to atma, it ceases to exist. So, adhyasa kartu abhavat. Anatma can superimpose upon Atma, provided it exists in Atma, it doesn't, therefore there is no adhyasa karta. So Anatma could not have superimposed itself on Atma. Dvitiye, Atma can do that because it is Svatantra. Svayameva sva anartham pravrittau, pravrittatvat. If Anatma is carried out the dhyarupana, then Svayameva sva anartham pravrittau, then it has accepted the samsara willingly. So willingly have accepted samsara, then adir moksha patti. If I have gone to prison on my own, and being svatantra, there is no question of releasing. If somebody has arrested me, then they can release me, I can be liberated, because I did not want to be in prison, and therefore there is always a possibility that whoever arrested me may release me if the right situation exists. But if I myself went there, they call us kshatriyas, you know, so kesariyas, come out, or kill us, you know, something like that. So who can stop them? And therefore, the anir moksha prasanga, if Atma has on its own deliberately created the dhyasa, knowing that I am entering a prison which is a source or which is a location of all misery, then Atma is no problem with that. That means there is no solution. If samsara is not a problem, samsara is a problem only when it is done unwillingly. If willingly it is done by Atma, then Atma does not see that as a problem, then there is no question of solution of problem, then there is no moksha, anir moksha prasanga. So ubhaya pasha rajyu. That means both ways, you know, either way, is like the double-edged sword, either way it doesn't make sense. So now let's see what the Guru has to say. The Tika says, Chinmatra Ashaya Vishaya Anadi Anirvachaniya Avidya Veshavashat Chidatma Eva Avidya Parikalpita Ahankaradi Sthula Shariranthaṁ Atmatvena Abhimanyamanaha Mithya Eva Adhyasakarta iti prasiddhim upagataha paramasatastu kutastha eva atman. So first, what is the nature of avidya? Point is, avidya or ignorance is the reason for adhyasa, not willingness. So, if you do not know that this is prison where you are entering, then you may as well enter. Thinking that this is an innocent place, you may go to forest. Not some people do all kinds of things and then they get trapped. You realize that you are totally lost and all kinds of animals are there. So, just because you entered the forest doesn't mean it's done willingly. It can be done out of ignorance. What's the nature of ignorance? Chinmatra ashraya vishaya. The ignorance, who is ignorant? Atma is ignorant. Ashraya means what? Ignorance is centered upon Atma. Means what? Atma is ignorant. And vishaya, ignorance also is about Atma, so Atma is ignorant about Atma. This is what we have to say. Something that is inexplicable. But what is ignorance? Ignorance is centered upon Atma, and also it is this object in Atma, meaning Atma is ignorant of Atma. That's the nature of avidya. Since when did this happen? Anadi. There's no reason why ignorance is there, meaning that this business has no beginning at all. How can it be? Anirvachaniya. Something that is inexplicable. That Atma is ignorant. Atma, that is of the nature of consciousness, the nature of knowledge, is nevertheless ignorance of its own self. where the word knowledge has two meanings. Satyam jnanam anantam brahma, when we say that jnana means consciousness. That illumines everything including avidya. So atma is of the nature of jnana or knowledge or consciousness, which is nirvishesham, which is universal, which illumines everything including ignorance. This is another jnanam, which is something that is opposed to ignorance. So sunlight, for example, is opposed to darkness. Where sun is, darkness cannot be. But then electricity also is also shining knowledge, not opposed to darkness. So there is one knowledge that is consciousness, which shines as I. It is unopposed to anything, therefore, it is not opposed to ignorance also. Only when vritti jnanam takes place, aham brahmasmi, I am Brahman, that is a knowledge that is opposed to ignorance. What is ignorance? Dehoham. Ignorance manifests as adhyasa. Some people's adhyasa is ignorance. There is no ignorance beyond that. That is another thing. But then, adhyasa superimposition cannot be unless there is ignorance. Therefore, there is the mula, vidya, etc. But what is the evidence of ignorance is adhyasa. That there is ignorance in our life is only established because there is aviveka, there is non-discrimination, superimposition, taking the body, mind, sense complex as I. Taking I as mortal, dukkhi, ignorance, sorrowful, sad, etc. So that is what our experience is, and that is ignorance. Or ignorance evident in that manner in our life. So that this is there, adhyasa is there, is a matter of experience. And adhyasa always is the result of ignorance, also is established. So avidya aveshavashat. The thing is that it is, there is as though an avesha or an identification with avidya. So anirvachani avidya vesha or avidya vesha, if you say the costume of ignorance or becoming one with avidya. Chidatma eva avidya parikalpita ahankaradi sthula sharirantam atmatvena abhimanyamana. So chidatma alone is the one that does the adhyasa superimposition and takes his I what? Avidya parikalpita ahankaradi sthu sharirantam. Thus chidatma has identified ahankara. Ahankara, the beginning from ahankara all the way up to the sthula sharira. Ahankara, then buddhi, then manaha, then sense organs and the body. All the way this chidatma has this superimposition. So first superimposition happens with aham vritti, ahankara. And then it extends to buddhi. Then that extends to manaha. That extends to sense organs. That extends to the body. Because this is the reverse process. So when you go to sleep, first the identity of the body goes. Sense organs goes. Then the mind goes. Then ahankara also goes in deep sleep. So therefore, just a withdrawal also is in a sequence, so also the superimposition also in a sequence. But all this ahankara, all the way up to deha, all of that is product of ignorance. The whole creation is the product of ignorance. So, avidya parikalpita. What is called creation? Creation is kalpana, again. Sankalpa. So you do not need anything more than a sankalpa. It's just a will, a thought arises and things get created. So avidya is the material cause. So avidya causes sankalpa. So kamam purusho nirvimana, as sankalpa arises, mountain, there is mountain, and elephant, there is an elephant. That's all you need. This universe also is a creation of sankalpa. Dream is a creation of individual sankalpa. This waking universe is a creation of the Ishvara sankalpa. or the sankalpa in the total mind. So that's called kalpana, which is a product of sankalpa, which does not need anything more than sankalpa. So avidya parikalpita, ahankara, and then the buddhi, then the manaha, then the sense organ, then the body. All of these are nothing but the creation of ignorance. Meaning that you do not require any substance other than ignorance to create all this. That's what it means. Although clay, etc., substance is there, but the clay is nothing but the molecules and atoms and stuff like that. It reduces the avidya. Atmatvena abhimanyamanaha. This Chidatma alone takes ahankara, all the way to body as Atma. Because of what? Anirvachani avidya aveshvashat. Because of the ignorance which is beginningless and which is inexplicable, cannot be categorized. So the ignorance is the reason. So why does Atma willingly do adhyasa? No. It is true that Atma does adhyasa, Anatma does not, cannot. But Atma, even though Atma is Svatantra, does not willingly enter the prison, does not willingly enter the body. It is ignorance because of which it does. Meaning that I may enter a prison without knowing where I am entering. And then I may wind up with all kinds of misery. Similar Atma, as though identifies or enters this upadhi and then finds it's miserable. So, there is initiative of dhyas on the part of Atma, but out of ignorance. So, both ways. How can you willingly enter something that is nothing but source of misery? He says, no, I entered all that, but not willingly, not knowingly. Willingly, but not knowingly. You can willingly do something and not knowing what you are doing. So, Atma did the adhyaropa. Entered meaning it did identify itself with the body, mind, sense complex. But not knowing what it was asking for. You know, then once you do that, you never realize that this is what I asked for, you know. And then, so I don't want it, but you have it now. So this is Atma Abhimanyamanaha Mithyaeva Adhyasakarta Yadi. So Atma is called Adhyasakarta. Atma is the one that brings about the adhyasa superimposition, but not really. If Atma knew what it was doing, then you can say that if I knew that I'm entering the prison, as they did actually, during the freedom movement, he knew where he was going. The freedom fighters willingly entered. Willingly they entered, became the first one. Blah, 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 again. So they were willingly done. But if a person doesn't know where he is going and what is going to happen to him, he thinks that everything is in order and then something happens, then you cannot say that he has done it. Although he has done it outwardly, but not intentionally, therefore he has not done it. It's out of ignorance it is done. So you can't say that he entered the prison on his own. So mithya. That Atma did the adhyasa, Atma is known to have done adhyasa, but that is what? Mithyaeva. So Atma is adhyasa karta iti prasiddhim upagataha. Atma is known as the one that carried out the adhyasa, but in a false manner, because he did not really do that. He did it, but did not really do it. He did it, but not knowing what it was doing. So you can say did it, adhyasa karta. But poor fellow did not know, they were mithya, not really. So, mithya eva adhyasa karta yati prasiddhi mupagataha. Atma is known to have done the adhyasa, but it is not really because it is out of ignorance that adhyasa is done. Paramatastu kutastha eva atma. In reality, atma remains kutastha. Anadhyasta, meaning that it abides in its own true nature, in its own glory, because this adhyasa is a product of ignorance, that it is not a reality. So that is what is called the samsarga adhyasa, you know, that the sun seems to have entered the water, but not in reality. And therefore, it is not willingness that is the cause of samsara. It is avidya that is cause of samsara. Understand this. So you see a person doing something and you conclude that he is doing it himself deliberately. But it may not be. Same thing you have done out of ignorance also. So there is a problem. Every day you did it. I didn't do it. Now you did it because you appeared to be doing it to that fellow. I did not because I didn't know. So this person doesn't say I did it because he is ignorant. You say you did it. I saw you because you think that he is deliberately doing it. You follow? How all kinds of problems arise in our life because of judging the situation differently. Somebody is innocent and does something. Why did you do that? I didn't do it. I saw you doing it. You saw me doing it, but I did not. I did not kartrutva in doing that. It happened, but not that I did it. You follow? So adhyasa happens, not that it is done. It looks like Atma has done that adhyasa because that alone is only conscious being in there, but that alone is freedom to do that. So ultimately the buck stops with Atma. And so you did it. He says, I didn't know. I haven't done anything. It has happened. So adhyasa happens and not that it is done. That being the case, to say that Atma is adhyasa karta or the agent of adhyasa is only mithya prasiddhi. That does not truly describe the nature of Atma. In reality, paramartha tastu kutastheva Atma. Atma remains kutastha in its true nature. Therefore, avidyana vrityacha samsara nivrittihi nidra nivritya iva swapna nivrittihi iti na anuvapannam kinchida iti abhipretya. So if there is a reason for adhyasa, then by removing the reason, adhyasa will go. There is no reason. I did it. There is no reason. Why did it? I did it. The children. Why did it? Because I did it. There is no reason. Then it will remain what it is. He told me to do that. Then there is some reason. Then you do something with that fellow and then remove the reason. Similarly, Atma says, I did not do it. Who did it? Ignorance has done it. Then you can remove the cause, which is ignorance, and then adhyasa goes. You follow? So, samsara is not the outcome of a willing thing. Samsara is the outcome of ignorance. Therefore, avidya nivritya cha. Because samsara, there is identification with the cause of avidya. Therefore, avidya nivritya. When avidya, the cause is removed, samsara nivritti. Then there is nivritti samsara. And a beautiful example is given. Nidra nivrityayiva swapna nivrityayiti. Same thing happens in swapna. Dream also looks like I have created this or that. You are the creator. You are not the creator of dream. If I am the creator of dream, I would not create this. You know? After dream, I wish I had not dreamt, you see. So many times, you know, there are miserable experiences in dream. Who will create? And still you are the only fellow who did it because you are the only conscious being. So you are the creator of dream, you can say, but no, out of ignorance it was done. Not knowing what was going to happen. Therefore, this since dream is a product of ignorance, that is sleep in this case, the nidra is a dosha. So because of dosha or the defect of nidra or the sleep that the dream is created, when the nidra, the cause goes away, the dream also goes away. Similarly, samsara is caused by avidya. If avidya goes away, samsara also will go away. So, anirmoksha prasanga. The disciple's concern was that if Atma willingly did this adhyarupa, then there will be no moksha because he has done it. He is the cause. If somebody made me do that, then if that cause goes away, then I can be reinstated in my old status. But I did it, then you can't be. And therefore, swapna nivrutti. Just tell swapna you are miserable. All that misery goes away. When the cause away, the sleep goes away. So also you are miserable when there is samsara. It goes away when the cause avidya goes away. Nanupannam kinchiditi. Therefore, There is nothing untenable. There is nothing that is contrary to reasoning. It all is understandable. It's all reasonable. Ida vipratya. This is what the teacher is in mind now. Then says Satika, shanayi shanayi uktartham shishya buddhim arohayate guruhu ityaha ityukto guruhu ityadinan. So this is what the guru wants his shishya to understand, but it's a little difficult to understand. So shanayi shanayi. So here the method is that the guru makes the shishya see. Our Swami used to say that the guru does not tell the shishya, makes the shishya see. So then only knowledge can take place. We cannot impart knowledge. We can impart the teaching. And knowledge will take place in the mind of the student. Therefore, the teaching should be imparted in such a manner that the knowledge arises in the mind of the student. So that can be in one stroke or a number of strokes or whatever. Shanahi, in this case, the guru sees that this is a very difficult thing or rather subtle thing to see. And therefore, shanahi, shanahi. Slowly the guru leads the disciple to make the disciple see this fact. Shishya buddhim arohayati guruhu makes this mount the shishya buddhi, makes, you know, this seal slowly arise in the or occur in the buddhi of the shishya. So with that guru vache. So guru doesn't tell him right away anadi avidya adhyaropa etc. So guru says, because why does guru say like this? Because slowly he wants the shishya to see. So the next passage says, ittuktaha guru ruvacha. So when he was told by shishya in this manner, thus both ways is unreasonable, that atma can do this or anatma can do that. Then guru has in mind what it is to make the shishya see. Guru said, so the tika says, so shishya said, maya eva chitimata atmani adhyaropana kriyate. If anatma does not do the adhyaropa, then I, the conscious being or consciousness, does the adhyaropa. Sarva anartha bija bhuta. That means I am willingly doing the adhyaropa, which is cause of all the anartha suffering. That's what it amounts to. This is where we are. What we said in between is what is in the mind of Guru. But what is in mind of Shishya is that Shishya says that either Anatma can carry out Adhyaropa or Atma. Anatma cannot because Anatma is Parartha, is Achetana. So Atma alone by Parishasanya is Karta of Adhyasa Karta. If I Adhyasa Karta means what one who willingly does things, that's called Karta. Karta means the one who deliberately performs action, not just performs action. And so all creatures other than human beings are not called karta, because they do not act deliberately. They act only instinctively. Therefore, they can't be blamed for what they do. Only human being can be blamed for what the human being does, because he alone has the capacity to deliberately do things. That is why in the court of law also it is established that this was done not deliberately, then the imprisonment is different, you know. So opposition will try to that this was deliberately done. That was I did not, I was drunk, I was something like that. You know, I was not in my own sense. So then also the point is that you are responsible or accountable only when something is deliberately. So Shishya thinks that Atma has deliberately done this adhyasa and enter into his samsara, which means there is no moksha. So I have done it, Shishya says. So then the tika says, Dehadi Atma Bhavanam అనర్థార్థం చేత్ అవగచ్చసి కిమిది తర్హి తాం నముంచసి స్వతంత్రత్వాత్ తవ. ఇది తావత్ సంఘాత విలక్షణతాం తస్య సూచయతి అనర్థ బీజభూతాం ఇది. సో శిష్య సేజ్ ఆత్మా హెస్ డన్ ది అధ్యారోప మీన్స్ ఐ హావ్ డన్ అధ్యారోప. సో దెన్ శిష్య దెన్ గురు సేజ్ దేహాది ఆత్మభావనాం అనర్థార్థం చేద్ అవగచ్చసి అవగచ్చ. నౌ యు సీ హావింగ్ డన్ ది అధ్యారోప యు సేడ్ ఐ హావ్ డన్ ది అధ్యారోప నౌ యు రియలైజ్ దాట్ ది దేహ ఆత్మభావనాం టేకింగ్ దేహ ఎట్సెట్రా ఇస్ ఆత్మ అనర్థార్థం దట్ ఇస్ ద కాజ్ ఆఫ్ ఆల్ ది అనర్థ సర్వ అనర్థ బీజభూత. ఇఫ్ దిస్ ఇస్ వాట్ యు రియలైజ్ దట్ వాట్ యు డన్ ఇస్ క్రియేటింగ్ ఆల్ మిజరీ ఫర్ యూ కిమితరి దెన్ వై డోంట్ యూ గివ్ ఇట్ అప్. ఇఫ్ యు రియలైజ్ దట్ యూ డిడ్ దిస్ అధ్యారోప అండ్ ఇన్అడ్వర్టెంట్లీ ఎంటర్డ్ ఇన్ టు దిస్ మిజరీ ఆల్ రైట్ గివ్ ఇట్ అప్ కమ్ బ్యాక్. కిమితః తరి తాం న ముంచతే వై డోంట్ యూ గివ్ ఇఫ్ యూ హావ్ డన్ ది అధ్యారోప వై డోంట్ యూ గివ్ ఇట్ అప్. శిష్య సేస్ ఐదర్ అనాత్మ క్యాన్ డూ అధ్యారోప ఆర్ ఆత్మ అండ్ ఆత్మ ఇస్ స్వతంత్ర కాన్షియస్నెస్ దే వర్ స్వతంత్ర దే ఆర్ విల్లింగ్ దే హావ్ డన్ ది అధ్యారోప హౌ కెన్ ఐ డూ దట్ హౌ కెన్ ఐ ఎంటర్ మై సెల్ఫ్ ఇన్ టు ఇస్ మిజరీ. సీ గురు సేస్ దట్ వెల్ ఇఫ్ యూ రియలైజ్ దట్ యూ ఆర్ ఎంటర్ ఇన్ టు సంథింగ్ దట్ ఇస్ మిజరేబుల్ దెన్ గెట్ అవుట్ గివ్ ఇట్ అప్. కిమితరి తాం న ముంచసి వై డోంట్ సింక్ అప్ దట్ అధ్యారోపణ స్వతంత్ర బికాస్ యు ఆర్ స్వతంత్ర ఆన్ యువర్ ఓన్ యు ఎంటర్ దిస్ సంసార దెన్ ఆన్ యువర్ ఓన్ యూ కెన్ కమ్ అవుట్ వై డోంట్ యు డూ దట్. ఇది తావత్ సంఘాత విలక్షణతాం. సో వన్ థింగ్ ఫస్ట్ పాయింట్ ఇస్ దట్ యూ హ్యావ్ ఎంటర్ ది ప్రిజన్ కాల్డ్ సంఘాత అండ్ యూ కెన్ కమ్ అవుట్ విచ్ మీన్స్ యూ ఆర్ డిఫరెంట్ ఫ్రమ్ సంఘాత. The Praveshakarta is always different from where the Pravesha takes place. Like Devadatta enters a house, is different from house. So Devadatta says, I have entered the house, you know, then you realize that it is a miserable place. Already you come out. So if you find now, having entered this house, you are all miserable, why don't you get out of it? So first thing is at least understand that you are not the house, so you have the freedom to get out. ఈ తావత్ సంఘాత విలక్షణతాం తస్య సూచయతి దట్ యు ఎంటర్ ది సంఘాత సూపర్ ఇంపోజ్ ఆర్ ఐడెంటిఫైడ్ ఇఫ్ యు డన్ ఇట్ దెన్ యు డి ఐడెంటిఫై. సో గురు సేస్ అనర్థ బీజభూతాం చేత్ మిథ్యా అధ్యారోపణాం జానీషే మా కార్షీ తర్హి. సో మిథ్యా అధ్యారోపణ అనర్థ బీజభూతాం జానీషే నౌ దట్ యు సీ దట్ దిస్ మిథ్యా అధ్యారోప ఇస్ సోర్స్ ఆఫ్ ఆల్ అన్హ్యాపీనెస్ సారో దెన్ డోంట్ డూ ఇట్ బికాస్ యూ డన్ ఇట్ యువర్ ఫ్రీడమ్ యువర్ స్వతంత్ర సో ఫ్రీడమ్ నాట్ టు డూ ఇట్ సో స్టాప్ డూయింగ్ ఇట్. దెన్ శిష్య సేస్ నైవ భగవన్ శక్నోపి న కర్తుం. భగవాన్ సో ద టీకా సేస్ సాక్షిణ కూటస్థత్వాత్ అనర్థ సంబంధ పరమార్థత ఇది ఉక్త అభిప్రాయం అనౌబుధ్యమాన శిష్య ప్రాహ. సో వెన్ ద టీచర్ సేడ్ దట్ if you did the adhyaropa then you give it up meaning you are not body mind sense complex that way you can give up. The point is sakshina kutasthatva sakshi or consciousness is kutastha paramartha kutasthayava atma you are unchained meaning that you are not become a samsari. Samsara is the product of superimposition ignorance and you are not samsari on your own. So no anartha sambandha. That means that there is only adhyaropa and not a real association with anartha. Dukkha sanyoga viyoga, dukkha sanyoga. the sanyoga or the connection with dukkha is not real. Otherwise you can't give it up. So na anartha sambandha paramartha. You feel that you are miserable, but in reality you are not miserable. When I say I am miserable, that means I think that misery and I are one, and therefore the misery is centered upon I. So it's not centered upon you. Not centered upon consciousness that you are. That is what Guru meant. When the Guru said, why don't you give it up? Means that you can give up, because right now also it's not on you. You can give up samsara like you can give up a costume. So by wearing the costume, you don't become a beggar. This man says, the costume is this beggar and I am the dhanvan, etc. And the costume cannot come to me. That I have entered into the costume. And then this costume is all beggar. That how can I do that? Beggar is miserable. So Guru says, if you realize that having put on the costume of beggar, you are miserable, give it up. Because you are swatantra. And you are not the costume. So that's the idea there. That even when you are wearing the costume of beggar, you are not a beggar. So even though you have worn the costume of the body, mind, sense complex, you are not there, but you can give it up. But he did not understand that. This is what Guru meant. And so, Shishya said, Naiva Bhagavan Shaknopi Nakartum Anyena Kenachit Prayuktoham Nasvatantrahiti. Tika says, Hey Bhagavan Nakartum Naiva Shaknomi Iti Anvayaha. I find that I don't have freedom not to do it. Now the Shishya says, you are chitimat consciousness, swartha independent, serving your own purpose. So you have the freedom to do what you want to do for yourself and not necessarily being compelled. But Shishya says, no, I can't seem to give up this adhyasa. Na kartum na shaknomi. See, give up the adhyasa, but I'm not able to give up. So I seem to be an unwilling, and still the adhyasa I can't give up. Meaning I do not seem to have freedom to give up this adhyasa. Therefore the Tika says, Anichato bime nivritti abhavat naham satantraha Anyenakenachit Pradyamanaiva Itimanye Ityarthaha. So Anyenakenachit Prayuktoham. Since I do not have the freedom to give up the adhyasa, that means that somebody is holding me in this adhyasa. Now I realize. It is true that Atma alone can do adhyasa, and Atma is Svatantra, so that means Atma is independent of adhyasa. If you independently done adhyasa and give it up, but I'm not going to give up, that means it's not independently done. So adhyasa is not the result of a deliberate effort. That's called ignorance. So anyena kenasat. Shishya, yes, Guru makes a shishya see how adhyasa is not a willing act. I'm not freedom to give up adhyasa, that means not willingly done adhyasa. If adhyasa was done willingly, then it can be given up willingly. If you enter a place willingly, you can come out willingly. But if you are unwillingly went in there, inadvertently went there, not knowing what it is, then you are trapped in there, then you don't know how to come out. So anyenakena chit, I don't seem to be free to give up this adhyasa. It is by someone else or something else that prayuktoham. I have this superimposition is there. Na svatantra. So Atma, I'm chitimat, consciousness, never swatantra, theoretical, but I find I'm not swatantra as far as the giving up of adhyasa is concerned. I'm not free in giving up adhyasa. So, anichyato vime nivrutya bhavat naham swatantra. Anichyata, even though I do not want this adhyasa, this samsara, nivrutya bhavat, but I'm not able to give up this samsara. I realize that I am not independent. Anyenakenachit Prayamanaiva iti. I seem to be prompted by or compelled by someone else. Eva, there is nobody else that can compel me, but as though I am compelled. This is what I believe, that it looks like, sir, I am not free. I am not independent. That as though someone else has thrown me into this, so it looks like endeavor, I am not able to come out on my own. So how Guru makes him progressively see what the whole situation is. Anyway, we'll have to continue in the next class. So, all this break is called rasa bhanga, you know, but anyway, unfortunately that's what it happens. Om Purnamadah Purnamidam Purnat Purnamudachyate Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnamevavashishyate. Om Shanti Shanti Shanti. Shankaram Shankaracharyam Keshavam Badarayanam Sutra Bhashyakrutau Vande Bhagavantau Punah Punah Ishvaro Guru Ratmeti Murti Bheda Vibhagine Vyoma Vadvyapta Dehaya Dakshinamurtaye Namah. Om Shanti 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 Hari Om Shri Gurubhyo Namah Hari Om.